Serious, late night hikers, what is the creepiest thing you have seen while hiking? Not intending to mock any religion or beliefs, and I really don't know which group this would be credited to anyway. Wiccans? Druids? Just a psycho? Anyway, I was hiking through a park in central Florida about 3 years ago. Kind of dense scrub brush. You can only see the trail in front of you. Brush is chest high on both sides. I'm about 2 miles from the nearest trailhead and it's around 7 p.m. I had an hour of light left. I had intended on setting camp when I found the next clearing. First clearing I get to has a gate ahead in the middle with a circle of stones around it. Maybe 2-3 weeks old. Just a dried skull with scales. Soft tissue was gone. I had seen gator skulls left by poachers before and I usually ignore it, but it gave me a weird vibe so I kept walking. About 15 minutes later, and deeper in, I get to another nice sized clearing. This time, a few dead birds were strung up to some sticks and hanging in a circle, like a mobile over a baby crib. 7 or 8 small birds, maybe 4 feet across, had been there for a while. It didn't smell anymore at least. Still creepy enough to send me on my way. Third time's the charm. Right? Wrong? 20 minutes later and after taking to side paths to get away from the main trail and hopefully avoid any other displays, I find a fresh one. A deer head on a stick. With sticks scattered around making 4 circles around the base of the stick. The blood was splattered all around the sticks. Fresh enough for the flies to still be on it. The head smelled rancid. Didn't see the body, but I didn't look for it either. I got out of there. I was dark before I got back to my truck. Called Fish and Game the next morning, because the gator and deer would have been taken out of season. I told them what I found and apparently this wasn't the first time somebody called about animal effigies in that park. Never went back, but I am curious just how many other shrines were out there. A bear. It wasn't late night but the sun was setting. A bunch of friends went up to a cliff diving spot that we knew. After a day of swimming and activities, a park ranger saw us and told us to follow a certain trail back to the parking lot because it's faster. This was a trail we haven't seen and we didn't take it up. We said frick it and decided it was okay. After about 1.5 hours of hiking and being lost on the trail, we come to a clearing in the forest with no more trail. Just what was left and a crap ton of vegetation. No problem. Turn around right. Now that was the first time I ever saw bear full on in person. The first thing I thought about was how fricked it would be if we had to run and even worse, someone getting caught. We just saw it, backed up, and decided frick it, better walk down the mountain than try to go around it. This isn't creepy but it definitely spooked me. We were camping upstate NY at a nice campground. 40 other campsites and it was at capacity. 10 p.m. is quiet time and enforced. It's around 1 a.m. and everyone is asleep. I'm dreaming and in my dream hear a young girl yell out help me from pretty far away. In my sleep I'm thinking wow, that's weird and realistic, and I hear it again and I wake up this time. I check on my kids, okay they are still there. It's pitch black outside and every time I heard it, I was asleep. So maybe I was dreaming it. Then I heard it for the third time, help me, being not yelled but loud with a definite sense of fear and urgency to it, and she's deep in the woods away from the campsite. This time it sounded further away than the last. I'm now trying to figure out what to do. Is somebody dragging her to her death? Is an animal attacking her? The middle of the night and it's pitch black outside of the tent. I arm myself with my pocket knife locked open and I leave the safety of my tent ready to attack, wondering what the news articles will say about my heroism and subsequent death from a murderer or wild animal. At this time there are other campers yelling out where are you? Follow with only a response from her help me, which is getting further and further away. I'm kinda freaked out at this point. So maybe 4 minutes have passed and other people have joined in the search. We hear somebody say we found her. I walk around to one of the that site with people that were searching for her and they said they found her. She was sleepwalking and walked into the woods. Apparently she does this a lot. Going back to sleep was challenging. I would not take a sleepwalker camping. Ever. Was camping in the mountains. In BC, Canada. And myself, friends and my dog had spent the day 4x4ing and decided to come back as it was getting dark fast. Truck breaks down and we decided we better walk back to camp. We were only about 2 kilometers away where we broke down. It was around 11 p.m. at this point, so very dark, and no one had a real flashlight, so we just walked with the moonlight. My dog was super on edge and was growling a lot and smelling around. He is a hound, so smelling is pretty normal, so I did not think much of it. But after a while he was really growling and was looking around rapidly and barking behind us, to the side of us, in front of us, and going nuts. My friend turned her phone light on to just look up ahead, and it was a cougar just standing in front of us on the trail. My dog went full howling at this point and was trying to run at it. He was on a leash, and the cougar took off. We were all terrified for the walk back. It made no noise the whole time we walk. Only reason we knew was because of the dog. I have a large farm in Gippsland, Australia. Most nights I would walk the fences with the dogs just to relax. This walk would usually take an hour and a bit. This one year in winter we had a very large collection of dead trees in the back paddock that we had decided to burn. Started the fire in the morning and let it burn all day. Every so often I'd go and check that it was okay. So it get to night, and around 9 p.m. I decide to go for my walk and check on the fire. Go to get the dogs and they just stayed in their kennels. Which was strange, but they had a big day herding. As I get down towards the fire I just get this chill through my body and start to feel unsettled. At this point I just beeline to the fire. As I'm about 5 meters from the fire I see a figure to my left but behind me by about 50 feet. At this point I think it's one of the dogs that has finally followed me. I turn to call it over and I get no response. I whistle some commands and still no response. It's just standing there. I'm crapping bricks at this point and move closer to the fire and grab a burning branch. I start to think I'm fricked, it's a wild dog, my wife will find me mauled. I decide to rush it and hopefully scare it off. I take 2 steps and this thing takes off like a bullet. The only noise is when it jumps the fence and hit the bush. I run back to the house to find the dogs all where I left them. The next day I go to check the fire with the dogs. Both of them refused to get out of the ute and even the cows wouldn't go near the area. I stopped walking after that and now I carry a knife with me when I go in that area of the farm. I went on a day hike in the prairies with a friend that ended up taking too long. And we were returning in the dim glow of twilight. The sun had just set, so the sky was still bright, but the ground was dark, so it was really hard to see where we were stepping, since our eyes wouldn't adjust to the dark ground when the sky in front of us was still lit up. I was in front of my friend, trudging through big tufts of grass up to our knees. I took my next step, and as my foot hit the ground, I suddenly heard a noise that nobody on the prairies ever wants to hear. By the time I had processed what noise I had heard, I was already sprinting as fast as possible away from its source. I stopped after about 30 meters to check if I had been bitten, but I was safe. I had stepped on a rattlesnake and gotten away with it. Not hiking per se, but I used to walk my dog, Boo and Anima, up in the access roads for the power lines in the town. They're probably 2-3 miles long, have a lot of ledges and obstacles. You have a nice view of the town below. It's just a nice place to walk your dog or jog or whatever. It was technically a restricted area on at the entries on either side, but people with houses around them could easily walk in through the woods, as I did. I'd see other people here and there walking their own dogs or jogging, but usually the same people. But it wasn't common to see people. So one day I'm walking my dog, Big Black Lab. He was almost 120 pounds but burly, not fat at all. But also the nicest and gentlest boy you'd ever meet. And he stops dead in his tracks and his ears perk up and he starts sniffing. Then he looks around behind me and starts staring. So I turn around and I see a disheveled, raggedy looking man sprinting toward us, probably 250 feet away. Then, when he sees me see him, he literally stops dead in his tracks and starts walking, as if I didn't just see him sprinting at me and he's trying to hide that he was just doing that. Now, I'm not at all trying to say I wasn't creeped, because I was, but with me fight flight is pretty much always fight. So my brain starts going and I decide the smart thing to do is stay put and not run. Let whoever this is know I have no reason to be afraid. So he approaches to talking distance and I wait for him to say something. I just stare at him holding the clip on the dogs, who is doing that soft, angry growl, where the hair on his back is standing up. BTW, and he never growled at anyone. So now my guard is through the roof. Leash, big dog man, he says. He bite, not as long as he's on the leash, I say, subtly playing with the clip on the leash with my thumb. Oh, hey, I'm looking for generic store, is it that way? And he points. Yay, I say. So he walks off and I stood there watching him get way beyond any distance that he could run and catch up to me again. What he wanted I have no clue, but I'm guessing to club me in the back of the head and rob me. But my boy had my back. Done tons of miles by headlamp. Creepiest thing I ever saw was just deer's eyes reflecting at me out of the darkness. Spooked tons of skunks, bears, and other animals. And the dang quail that wait until you are right on top of them and then all freak out at once. Got woken up miles into the backcountry once by what I thought was a car horn. But it was just a flock of geese flying overhead. And walking through a cattle herd in the dark can be freaky. Especially if you don't realize you are walking through a cattle herd. Went for a midnight pee right outside my tent. Had my headlight on a super low setting so my eyes wouldn't have to adjust too much. And of course when I look up mid-pee there's two eyes about 15 featuring away staring at me. Huge sigh of relief when I realized it was a deer, but yeah, the eyes are pretty creepy at night. I will say one thing. One thing you do not want to hear out late past midnight in the middle of the woods is a cougar screaming. It's one of the most terrifying things you will ever hear. And at night, pitch blackness, it will absolutely see you long before you even know it's there. Plus it's an unearthly sound in of itself. When one wakes you up at 3 in the morning while you're sleeping peacefully in a tent by yourself, that's the scariest thing you will ever hear in your goddamn life. I went on a night hike about 12 years ago with a meetup group, just to experience one. I knew no one there and I'm not one to make small talk. There were about 25 people there and beforehand we met in a small cabin on the property where the organizer laid down the rules. This person was stern. We were to remain completely silent and listen to the night sounds. Keep up with the leader. It was certainly creepy, walking quickly and quietly through the dark woods with strangers at your back. I think the leader was too rigid, and no one seemed to enjoy the experience. As soon as I spotted my car, I got in it and left. I feel like someone else's story is going to be because of you creepy freaks. 25 people not talking and moving quickly through the woods at night would be horrifying to hear getting closer to you. My mom decided to take us on a late night hike. She claimed she saw a mountain lion and she made us run the fastest we've ever ran in our little lives. I think she actually saw a piece of shrub. It was really scary at the time. That's the scary thing about mountain lions. If they want you dead, you're dead. You probably won't even know they're there, but they'll stalk you. Come from behind and go for the neck. You're just walking along, you hear a light rustle behind you and then black. Scary predators. When my now wife and I first started dating, we would take long walks through our very small town after I got off work at 11 p.m. We would wander through the cemetery, down little country roads, everywhere. But our favorite area was a large field where the stars were incredible. One night we were watching a small meteor shower and heard all kinds of loud grunting and ruckus coming from a tree line. We had nowhere to go and were starting to get concerned. A large, angry buck came out, stared at us, and then quietly walked away. I don't think we breathed for several minutes. I was convinced he was coming at us and there was no way to outrun him. We didn't go back there for a few days. I took my kids on a camping trip once, not alone in the woods, at a campground, but our site was surrounded by woods. After they fell asleep one night, I tossed and turned for a while and then decided to walk my dog to the end of the lane and sit on the bench in the children's playground. I was just enjoying the late summer air and my normally very calm lab was starting this very low growl. She kept it up despite my shushing her and kept staring into the playground. There was an old metal swing set with 4 swings, and all of a sudden, just one of the swings started swinging by itself. Initially I thought wind might be stirring it, and I sort of froze just watching it pick up speed while my dog erupted into barking. I bolted back to the tent and did my best not to wake my kids, but I just could not calm down. I've never told them what happened. I got a good one. I was looking for worms on a stormy night on my well-lit street for fishing the next day. Worms love the rain and were filling the streets. I wasn't finding anything worthwhile, so I headed home. I knew a spot in my backyard that always had good-sized worms. I walked into my dark backyard with my dying headlamp and began to look around. I couldn't hear a thing due to the patter on my raincoat. I felt the shiver like I normally do when I'm being watched. Wasn't the first time. My headlamp had a setting that would burst light for a few moments then diminish back to a very low setting when the batteries were low. I looked around and saw a set of yellow eyes staring at me from the brush about 20 yards away. My stomach dropped and I immediately drew my combat knife. I live in Colorado and knew that first they weren't the blue eyes that deer put off and second they were higher off the ground than a normal cat would stalking at. I tapped my light and saw a fully grown adult mountain lion watching me. Then, my light dimmed down back to its low light setting, while the cat looked away and I lost complete sight of it. I covered my throat with my arm with a shovel in it and slowly backed up to the stairs of my house while scanning every inch that my poorly lit headlamp could cover. I made it inside with my heart pounding. I believe that if I wouldn't have had that feeling, I wouldn't be here today. My back was completely turned to the cat and it could have been on my neck in a matter of seconds, killing me. If you are ever in the Rockies, scan at night and if you know you are being stalked, face the cat, cover your neck, and back up to friends or a safe location. For every one cat you see, at least 10 have seen stalked you. Used to go on holiday to the south of France every year with my parents. They were big into walking and seeing the surrounding area, so my sister and I would always be dragged along with them. There was one time we had stopped to eat dinner at the top of a mountain. Probably one of the longest walks we'd been on since my sister and I were only around 10 and 12 years old. Whilst we were sat on some boulders eating, this old French lady, probably around 70 years old, approached my parents and asked if they could show her the way down the mountain as she was looking for her husband. Bear in mind this was a very isolated spot and we hadn't seen any other people on this entire walk. My parents were confused how such an elderly old lady had made it so far up the mountain in such heat and no hiking gear. They attempted to communicate with her and see if she had any explanation of how she got there, but she insisted that she just needed to find her husband. As we started walking back down the mountain, she began to follow us. All of my family were wearing hiking boots and using sticks to aid us in our descent as the path was incredibly steep and we all slipped many times. The old lady, however, did not struggle. She followed us down without misplacing a step. The creepiest thing about her though, was that the entire way down all she would say was "ooh la la" anytime any of my family slipped or seemed to struggle finding the right place to put our feet. Once we reached the bottom of the mountain and were on the path back to the car park, she said thank you and began following the path we had taken to get to the top of the mountain. She is now referred to in my family as the "ooh la la woman." My story became creepy after the hike, not so much during. It was a mild December day in New England and my then girlfriend and I decided to do a short evening hike at a local state park, an easy trail up to this old stone tower structure. We brought a little weed with us and hung out on top for quite a bit until it started to get dark. We smoked a bit, talked, and enjoyed the views. The tower overlooks the trail heading up to it, and as we were up there we noticed someone walking up the trail to the tower. It was a man, dressed in black, just casually making his way up. Now me, being a teenager at the time and a little stoned, glanced to see the man coming to the tower and quickly packed up my stash for discretion. We decided to just start our hike back as it was near dark anyways. But as we make our way down each of the 3 or 4 levels of the tower, we realize we don't see the man. The stone structure is large but open and with many windows, so I kind of look around curiously just to see who had hiked up. No sign of him, and no sign of him around or on the trail either. You can see a good distance in every direction leaving the tower, certainly enough to see someone a few seconds after they turned around to leave. He had left somehow. It confused me but I was also kind of stoned. So we paid no mind to where he went really and just made our way back to the car. Now where it gets creepy is that few months later, I found out that my experience was not unique. I discovered that there were similar stories about a ghostly legend of the state park. I was really interested in the paranormal at the time, and while researching local ghost stories online I found the story of the man dressed in black. He is sometimes seen near dark walking up to the stone tower, and some claim that if you keep your eyes on him long enough, he'll just disappear. I was flooded with chills when I read about it, and I'm just glad that ghost didn't cross my mind when I saw him. Me and my family went to our local mountain to look at the massive amount of snow it had gotten in the past few days. From Arizona, so snow is rare. We were walking down the trail when all of a sudden our dog stopped and started to growl down the path. Now this dog scares himself awake with his own fart, so he is easily scared off, but not this time. He just looked down the trail and was growling. We tried to get him to keep walking forward, but he wouldn't walk forward and was being dragged as we tried to keep going. We stopped and tried to pet him and make him feel better, but he wouldn't even look at us. Just whatever was behind us in the trees. He was smelling or seeing something that he didn't like, and when me and my father tried to go down the path alone, he would start barking at us as if he was so scared for us and was panicking that we were getting closer to whatever he didn't like. We stopped and just went back down the trail back to our cars. We told everyone that was coming down the trail what we heard, and most of them blew us off, but some just turned around with us and walked someplace else. I am happy we never found what he was so scared of. I am sure it was a bear or maybe a mountain lion, but it could have been anything. A dead tree that had a hole in it that was filled to the brim with mint lifesavers. This hike was about 5 years ago with a couple friends up in the mountains. I mean, one of us found half of a deer jaw before finding the mint tree, and that friend decided to keep it, but I figured that that's pretty common considering there's plenty of deer and mountain lions in the area. But mint lifesavers stuffed in a tree, and not just any tree, either. This tree was found on its own path, in its own little secluded area with other trees being spaced out from it as if it was intentional. IDK what type of tree it was, but it was fat and twisty like an oak tree, but not as tall, and its bark wasn't as harsh. It was white and leafless, which is why we assumed it was dead. So yeah, if not creepy, then hopefully at least funny lol. Years ago, before we got married, my wife and I went to a local state park with a picnic and a hammock. We set the hammock up in the woods, enjoyed our picnic, then fell asleep together in the hammock. I was abruptly awakened by my wife. She motioned for me to be quiet. The sun had set. There was still a hint of light in the sky, but we couldn't see anything meaningful in the woods. My wife beckoned me to listen. Complete silence. Then, the snap of a branch in the distance. More silence. We were both suddenly very on edge. We whispered to one another, trying to figure out if someone was sneaking up on us. The silence was broken again. Another branch. Same direction but closer. Then, from another direction, a momentary crunch of leaves. Now, we were terrified. We both had pocket knives on us. Small but better than nothing. We also had a flashlight. We drew our knives and deliberated whether whatever was out there knew our location. We decided to keep the light off, lest we give away our exact location. Maybe we could run for the car. More steps, in rapid succession, coming directly toward us. Then silence again. My wife had enough. "We know you suckers are out there," she yelled. Silence for an eternity, and then another crunch of leaves. We had enough. We prepared ourselves as best we could for a fight, then shined the flashlight into the darkness, toward the last noise we had heard. Three deer scampered away, into the darkness. We sheepishly gathered our things and left without incident. This story pleases me. Creepy but with a feel-good ending. We used to go night hiking when there was a full moon. In the summer it's painfully hot during the day, so we would night hike instead. My boyfriend and I had just finished a big loop and were about a mile before the trailhead. He pointed into the trees on the hillside and said, "Check out that owl." You could see two big yellow eyes up between the trees and the slope. Then its head moved. Definitely was not an owl. Definitely was a cougar that had been watching us. Went to northern Michigan to try and photograph the stars. First night was cloudy, so I drove off at 11:30 p.m. On the way home there was a clearing, so I stopped to see if the clouds were still covering in that area, which they were. I was out for about a minute just looking. I get back in my car and turn my music back on. Look up and in the headlights there's a wolf walking across the road. Creeped me out. We were hiking on a trail in Hawaii and it was getting late. Few people were on the trail, but they were rare. My dad and I were walking up the trail and we then get a call from my stepmother saying that she had heard some animal grunting in the bushes as she was nearing the end of the trail. She had finished the trail before we did. She thought it sounded like a pig. Wild boars can do some damage, and I knew they killed humans sometimes. So my dad and I each grab a branch and stone just in case. We didn't want to hurt it, but it would likely feel threatened if it saw us near its young and strike if deemed necessary. We walked up through the vegetation, a lot of branches on this trail, in complete silence to try to listen for this animal. I eventually spot it like 7 feet to my left. It was big, had short black hair, or fur, and didn't look like it had spotted us. I told my dad to keep moving cause we were within earshot and I noticed it was distracted, likely caring for its young. We hurriedly walked further up and eventually exited the trail. I saw another hiker about to enter. I genuinely don't know why it was so late, and I handed him my branch. Who knows? He may need it. This doesn't answer your question, but if I was in different circumstances then it would. So to start off, I live right next to a boardwalk, so sometimes during the summer I run walk the length and back to my place, which is about 2.2 miles. One day at around 6 a.m. I saw a single person lying on the beach. I thought nothing of it. There were surfers always arriving this early to catch the early waves and not pay the beach entrance. So after my run walk I shower and go back to bed for 4 more hours or so. Well, when I wake up I put on my TV and on one of the local news channels I saw that a person was found dead on the beach bare this block in that street. I realized instantly that it was the person I saw on earlier. The person was found by a person running with his dog on the beach. Thinking it was a drunk, he walked up to her and when she wasn't moving and her face blue, he called paramedics. Dead at the scene. I know it isn't what your question asked, but I just wanted to say what I saw and could have experienced if I was in the position of that guy running on the beach. Hiking the PCT always brings a new challenge, whether it be realizing that you actually wear size 11 boot when you've worn 10.5 for the last 3 years. It's quite wild how the smallest thing can become the biggest pain in your butt. Anyway, the biggest fright I had at night was realizing another hiker was following me. You think maybe he was just matching speed, but when you realize it's been 3 days and he's said nothing is very sus. Most people are very welcoming and will set camp, but he was always there. It escalated to the point when one night I just had the most overwhelming sense of someone watching me, and upon exiting my tent I see a figure maybe 15 feet from me looking right at me. I was so shocked that I just froze and the man took off running. Needless to say, I slept with my pocket knife on me that night lol and just hightailed it the frick out of there. I actually beat my best one day and marked 20 miles before I hit Stevens Pass. I am not actually a late night hiker, but grew up with a house backing onto woods with trails that led up to the fuel breaks. It was crime filled. It was the late night track for thieves. Our house got broken into 6 times and stolen stuff from other places would often end up on our lawn. We had a dog and a rabbit stolen, but creepiest thing was someone tried to break in while we were home and awake. This happened 30 years ago and I still remember the guy's face. I was very young, but I have had nightmares ever since because of it. But it would not be unusual to see people hiding at the entry to the trail in our backyard. This was the 80s, so we were left alone as kids a lot as well at home or told to go play in the backyard. I was terrified of it at night. On bright sunny days I was fine, but any time it was not completely bright it was completely terrifying. My mum just thought we were being silly. I know this isn't hiking, but it's certainly creepy and at night. So this was about 2 years ago in my garden at about 3 a.m. I just got a puppy and he'd wake me up to go outside at silly hours of the morning. Anyway, I heard a couple days before from one of the neighbors that someone was standing on her shed roof just laughing at her and her family while they were watching TV. They called the police, but he was gone as soon as he heard the sirens. Apparently someone else around the corner reported the same thing a week before, but he apparently had some sort of shiv, but the police didn't find him. Back to my part in this. So my lovely little papa was running around the garden and I was just standing there looking around and I saw him standing on someone else's shed. I grabbed my pup and ran in the house. I think I threw an orange at him to try and scare him off, but he didn't even budge. I was about to call the police when I heard a screech and saw loads of police running down the alleyway by my house. I turned to look at the guy, but he was gone. The police called for a helicopter and everything. He was never found but stopped doing it. I personally suspect it as being the Croydon, London, UK cat killer, as both people had cats, but who knows. Generally feeling shaken up remembering it all as I'm writing this. Late to the party, so this'll likely be buried, but whatever. I went backpacking fishing overnight with a female friend. We're both fairly experienced backpackers and it was a spot we'd been to many times before on the Salmon River in upstate NY. We also brought her collie along with us. We parked in the same spot we always did at the end of a dirt road, and hiked in about 45 minutes to our favorite fishing spot. Had a great day knocking back beers, swimming and pretending to fish. We put out the fire and went to bed around midnight. We were awakened about 3 a.m. by the creepiest noise I've ever heard in my life. It honestly sounded like a demon, groaning and growling away maybe 5 feet back from the edge of our site in some thick brush. Her usually fearless dog was cowering in the corner of our tent. I was kinda spooked but I calmed myself down, ran through the local wildlife in my head and decided it was probably a bobcat. For anyone who doesn't know, bobcats aren't very dangerous but they can make some supremely freaky noises. Their territorial growls often sound like human screams or crying babies. I grab my mess kit, the BSA style one where one half is a frying pan and the other is a bowl, and head outside to try to scare it off. I repeatedly bash the two halves together as loudly as I can to frighten it, which has always worked in the past. I've even run off black bears a few times with this method. The thing did not move. If anything, it got closer. I try not to attribute human emotions to wild animals but the growling sounded angrier. At this point my friend and the dog are out of the tent and Mr. Fearless is trying with all his might to drag her back down the trail toward the road. I shine my light into the dark and it reflects off of a pair of eyes that I swear looked human, peering out from a bush at about my chest height. Maybe it was crouching, maybe it was standing on something, but it dang sure wasn't a bobcat. I'm not proud of this but we fled in disarray, slept in the car in a McDonald's parking lot and went back to get our stuff in daylight. Nothing was taken but the site was tossed, even the tent interior. The one sensible thing I had managed to do during our retreat was re-zip the tent but it was open. Not all open, unzipped. Still have no idea what the heck that thing was. Haven't camped there since. Scout leader here. I love telling ghost stories to the scouts around the campfire when we're hiking. This thread is gold. If you are new to the channel, you can subscribe. I publish new videos every day. Until then, check another video. Bye for now.